When it comes to quality and quantity, there are different types of strengths and weaknesses for each of them. Basically, quality has me as like basically having the unit being a little bit powerful than, you know, most units. Quantity just being like, you know, just large numbers, basically, you know, strength through numbers, quality through like just having a few, but the many trained or many like armored or good equipped, basically, you know. And different like RTS games do have some like favorites when it comes to like quantity over like quality or quality over quantity. And today I'm going to show you about quality and quantity in RTS games. Hello everyone, I'm JK, this is my channel. What's up everyone, before we get started today, I just want to know about my Twitch channel. I'm going to be streaming on the 24th of December for this week for a 12-hour charity stream for the No Kid Hungry organization. If you guys do support that kind of stuff, make sure you guys come onto my Twitch channel in which I'll be doing a 12-hour stream of it. Our goal is to try to raise about $100. Any penny given to the organization will help them a lot through their cause, basically. So I'll be starting on the 24th of December, starting at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. You guys can look on it on my social medias, on Twitter, Instagram, and on my Discord as well. Basically, I do update them 24/7 whenever it comes to like announcements or just events. So if you guys do want to come to my Discord channel, you guys can come down there, basically. And also, if you guys are interested of a free 4-week RTS program with me, basically, whenever it comes to beginner RTS games, so that you guys can know how to play RTS games in the future, then you guys can contact me, DM me on Discord that you guys are interested, basically. I have a lot of slots, basically. And if you guys do want to be featured on YouTube, then yeah, why not give this a shot here, ladies and gentlemen. I'm still in beta program. I'm still trying to improve a couple of things with the RTS coaching program. If anyone's interested more on like how to play RTS games, then this is the spot for you guys. All right, without further ado, let's get started here, ladies and gentlemen. In RTS games, quality and quantity are things you need to look out for. But each RTS games can be different. Games such as like Empire War, they do value more of the quantity, strength in numbers, than of like games such as Age of Empires 2, which favors more of quality. Like Empire War, I don't know why it's more of quantity, but they just favor more of quantity. I've done a lot of only use challenges on this channel, so you guys can check that out, basically. But majority of time with Age of Empires 2 is way different than Empire War, because of the fact, even though you're in like the stage of like the castle age, basically, you can still upgrade your units to have better armor, to have better attack speed, and all of that, and then they could go up against a faction that has already upgraded to the Imperial Age, which is like the top like level, basically, and they could still handle themselves a pretty good fight, to be honest. So there's that. Total War games such as Rome 2 Total War, they do value in more with the balance of like quality and quantity units, especially also with Warhammer 2 as well, as I've seen. But Rome 2 Total War kind of has, you know, more, a little bit more of that, to be honest. Because of the fact that, like, even though like you have more units with lower quality, you'll still need to be a match of the lower like quantity army, but with more higher quality, basically. And when it comes to that, like, it really comes down with strategy. So like games like those like have a balance between quality and quantity, but some majority of games that I've seen before have more favorites with like quality or with like quantity, basically. Do you favor more lower numbers but with higher quantity units, or do you favor in lower quality or higher quantity of units, more strength in numbers? So I'm gonna be telling you guys about the differences that I found in each of them and the pros and cons, in my opinion, about these guys. All right, let's get started with quality. What is quality? So quality is basically like what the amount of value do you have for each unit. And the value for each unit when it comes to like higher quality would be like more higher than like what you have with favor more of quantity, basically. So like each like person or each soldier that you have in battle, or each ship they have in battle, depending on what RTS game you have, will be equal to like more than like of one, basically, you know. So for example, like a Spartan Hoplite would be worth like, you know, 5 Athenian Hoplites, I guess, you know. I'm not gonna go into, you know, computations of like, and everyone knows about the 300 movie, I believe. I don't know everyone knows it, but I'm pretty sure everyone does. Such an inaccurate movie, but you know, I'm pretty sure we all get the point. 300 Spartans like go up against 250,000 Persians, basically. you know, the reason why was basically, unlike the movie, you know, in history, you know, Spartans have higher quality of armor. The shields of the Spartans were able to block against the Persian arrows, basically just bouncing on like, wing, 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 wing. I don't freaking know, but, you know, you get the point against. And that was even like, that was better than like what the Persians had basically, which was like the, I believe it was a Wickerman shield, I believe. A little bit larger, but like, you know, nothing can really protect you with that basically, so yeah. You know, quality over quantity basically. I believe like the good things about quality would probably be of, you know, just like, you know, you don't really need to produce that many like units with the more quality units, because of the fact they could probably take on like, you know, more large units basically. So if you only have a couple of them by your side, then you could be able to like, you know, concentrate on other things basically. You know, that could be like the pro basically. You know, that's the only strength that I've seen. You know, you don't need to recruit as many units, you know, as much basically. And that's basically it in my opinion with like, you know, quality units. I kind of balanced the both of them, but we'll get into that, you know, a little bit later though. But with the weaknesses of like more quality units is basically like they're expensive, you know, to produce. They might take a while to produce, like in many games. Some of the times, like when it comes to like divide and conquer, you can't really divide and conquer in a large space of a map, or in which like a campaign map or in the battle map, basically. Because if you do, then your forces will be spread out and they'll be vulnerable to more attacks from other people, basically. And you will not have anyone or anything for them to be reinforced, but they can probably hold the ground. But it's not only a if they can lose, only when they lose the battle, basically. So you really gotta make sure, you know, you gotta have some other units to back them up as well with like the higher quality units. All right, let's get on to quantity, you know, strength in numbers, basically. You know, you'll have lower quality of units, but you'll have more of them at your disposal. So the strengths of like quantity of units will probably be, you know, you have like more numbers at your disposal. Like I said before, you know, you could be able to overwhelm an enemy if there's only one or a couple of them basically. So just overwhelm them, and you have more flexibility with like the units basically. So I feel like with more quantity of units, you have to be a little bit more aggressive in my opinion. So like be able to spread out a ton of them like across the map. You can be able to reinforce them in any kind of way basically. And like in any case, you know, you could be able to use some one of the like units and use them as like some bullet sponge, or use them as like a, you know, kind of like a body shield, so that, you know, your units can like flank or use can be used as a counterattack basically by using your other units behind them. So those are kind of like the strengths that I've seen with like the quantity of units, you know, just more flexibility, more of like spread, and just being able to be more aggressive, having a lot more tools at your disposal basically. The weaknesses with quantity though, because every kind of thing has its own weakness, the weakness with quantity is basically the quality of your units, you know, because you don't really have good quality units, they'll probably die more easier. And whenever it comes to higher quality units, you'll probably need to have like 3 or 4 men to take out that just one like trained soldier or whatever basically, you know, just overwhelmed with numbers. But you really need to invest more of those guys on one person basically. As much as with like, you know, quality of units, whenever it comes to like flanking, they probably might be able to do the job with like flanking units. Like I said before, quality of damage, quality of speed, quality of armor will be very low. So you guys gotta make sure whenever it comes with like lower quality units but more quantity of them, you gotta make sure you really do need to preserve them, because you only can get so many, to be honest. You know, as much as you can produce many, you know, they're cheap, you know, you need to produce like hella more in order to like replace one of them or whatever. But you really need to like concentrate on basically like just who should I like go out against, you know, who should I attack first, and like, is this, you know, higher quality unit gonna really take out my entire army or my entire like, you know, flanks basically. So those are the things you really need to like look out for. I feel like this is kind of like a, you know, two restaurants basically. One favoring more variety of like foods basically. We'll kind of name that as like the more quantity type of restaurant. And then the restaurant that has only like a couple like foods on the menu basically, we'll call that as the quality of it basically. So like whenever I went to a restaurant that had a lot of variety of foods, the quality of the foods in general was not really good. So the more variety they had, the less quality like they were able to produce basically. With fewer menus, like the low fewer menu restaurant basically, their quality of food was so good. Like for example, basically like a good burger restaurant would like only have a couple burgers on the menu, but they'll be so good, man. Like because the quality and concentrating like all your efforts on those kind of like types of foods are like top notch, the best in my opinion basically. With like, you know, with the restaurant with the higher quantity of foods, with the more variety of foods, you know, as much as you have a burger, you have spaghetti, you have fish, you have chicken, you have salad, you have pasta, you know, all those kind of things, you need to split all your efforts on all of them basically, you know. So I mean, like their strengths and weaknesses for both of them, you know, one doesn't have the variety of foods, you know, and one doesn't invest enough on one of their foods basically. So, you know, one for more investment, one for more variety basically. So that's what I kind of have with like quantity and quality of units basically, is that like, you know, you put in more effort with like one unit, they could go up against like more, but with the more quantity of units basically, you can basically be able to do more options, you have more variety. But like the end goal for everything would probably be to like try to eliminate each other. So that's why like quality and quantity kind of, you know, have equals, and they do kind of have like the equals, they do kind of have the balance of each other in my opinion, to be honest. So there's that, you know. And what I think about like quality of units, I think about more defensive units basically, more being on the defensive side, because you can't really be aggressive, to be honest. If you're being more aggressive, then you really aren't really like supporting your units basically, because if you're just like spreading them all out trying to go after all these units, then you know they're gonna be surrounded basically. And with like quality units, they could be more aggressive towards like the enemy, so they just swarm in and to like spread out towards the map, because there's more numbers with them than anything else. My freaking mic just hit myself. I hit my mic. But that's what I think about like quality and quantity. You guys might be asking me like, you know, what's better, quality or quantity? Well, I could probably say a little bit of both, to be honest, you know, because of the fact, you know, not only you can have defensive units of higher quality units to be able to like be the front lines of your army, you can have some lower quality units and they can be more on the aggressive side. So if you guys do check out my video of like Rome 2 Tours, for the tactics that you should use for beginners basically, that's going to teach you guys about like, you know, having a variety of quality of units basically, but at the same time being able to like max out the 20 unit cap in Rome 2's Total Wars like multiplayer basically. So a balance between both of them in my opinion is the best, but it could be my opinion though, because of the fact, you know, I'm still learning all this, you know. Many other people might have their own opinions, their own playstyle. Maybe some of you guys with all RTS games would just do all quantity or just all out quality or something like that, you know, depending on your guys' like playstyle. Do you guys like, you know, defensive measures, or do you love offensive measures basically, you know? Let me know in the comments below what you guys think, you know. And yeah, thanks for watching the video. Make sure you guys let me guys know what you guys think about like, you know, quality or quantity, you know, which one is better in your guys' own opinions, and like what other videos that I can do for you guys whenever it comes to like the units only challenges with like RTS games. I'm already doing more of like Empire War, so you know, stay tuned for that. And like subscribe and like, you know, if you guys do like this more content with RTS beginners guides, you know, because I know a lot of you out there do need this kind of stuff, you know, do want this kind of stuff, because you guys are trying to get into RTS games and you're kind of unsure of it because it's hard as hell. I was there, you know, we've all been there once, you know. Why not I'll probably just teach you guys, you know, because of the fact you guys, you know, there's not really a, you know, for to be honest, like there are guides out there whenever it comes to like RTS games, but the majority of time that I've seen is like, you know, there's some like beginners guides, but like majority of time it's just how to be like a professional, how to get good at this game, you know. I believe the foundations of like the basics in RTS games are way more important than you just finding out, oh, how do I become a phase motherfucker? How do I become an FPS like master at this? How do I become a professional at this? Like all of a sudden you're just jumping out of the corner, just like you're jumping like the beginning, middle, and just going towards the end basically, you know. Can't do that on RTS games without knowing the foundations though, in my opinion. But But anyways, thank you for watching today. And, you know, like I said before, the 24th of December, we will be doing our charity stream for 12 hours for the No Kid Hungry organization. And we'll also be doing an Meeple card giveaway. So I have some right here, basically. They're pretty small, but I tried them on the Switch, on my Switch, and they've been pretty good, to be honest. So I haven't tried all of them, you know. So if you guys are wondering, I have not accepted any of them because I already have 12 villagers. No, not 12, 10. You know, that's gonna be the giveaway stream, 12 hours on the 24th of December at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. My Twitch link will be below, so follow me there so you guys can get the notifications on when I go live here, folks. Well, without further ado, everyone, I'll see you guys next time, or I'll probably see you guys on December 24th for the Republic, and I'll see you guys next time. You guys have a good day.